But when a UFO encounter is witnessed not just by one or two civilians, but by hundreds, if not thousands, the U.S. authorities have their work cut out to keep the incident under wraps. Phoenix, Arizona, March 1997. An electrical storm appears to short-circuit the city's electrical grid. As darkness descends, unexplained bright lights appear in the night sky.
Look at that. There's another one. We're just excited. They keep coming. Wait, look at them all. I got that one on video.
There's four of them. Look at, there's three of them all together.
I got the third one popping.
There's one behind the chimney. One just flared up.
I got four of them. Major sighting here.
There's five.
Oh!
Another one just showed up.
They're multiplying.
Whoa! I can't see how this works. How does this work?
The first report of the movement of the giant body in the sky came at about 6:55 in the evening from Henderson, Nevada. The dark V-shaped object with five bright lights moved slowly towards the southeast. Other reports followed, accumulating at 10:30 when a series of bright lights were seen hanging above the western Phoenix skyline before gradually submerging behind the Sierra Estrella Mountains.
What they were reporting are these large black triangles that are able to hover and then also travel at very fast speeds. That's a sort of technology that we do not have, or at least if we do, the public is certainly not aware of it. And for this to be happening in the 90s would be even more extraordinary.
So that it was time to end months of speculation on the question and investigate the matter once and for all to clear it up.
Attempting to defuse public alarm, Arizona Governor John Fife Symington holds a press conference at which he jokingly presents a member of his staff dressed in an alien costume. However, in 2007, after leaving office, Symington confesses that this was just a way to appease public concern and that he remains convinced to this day that something extraterrestrial visited Arizona that night.
Thank you.
I think it was a very, I think it was a legitimate occurrence of unknown origin craft of some sort, who knows where it came from. Inexplicable, and probably one of the major sightings in modern history in the country, because a lot of people saw it in Maricopa County, and I saw it too. I used to work, when I was first in the Air Force, I worked at Luke in the SAGE Center there in NORAD. And so something like that would go up the chain of command immediately to NORAD in Colorado and then go to the Pentagon.